you go, Doctor Who. And if you don't, then you can go.
Right, hello guys, we're watching Go Doctor Who. Today we're going to do five Doctors. We're going to review the five Doctors. We reviewed the three Doctors, and now we're reviewing the five Doctors, and then we're going to review the two Doctors, and then the Ark Infinity, and then Genesis of the Daleks to round off Classic Month on the channel. Now, let's get on to it. There is a lot to talk about in this episode. It's an hour and a half long. So yes, the fifth Doctor is with his companions, as you do. I like that, as we're just settling around in the TARDIS, rattling about, and then the Doctor's, there's something wrong with the Doctor, and he's collapsing, and he's fading away. I like that. And it's quite, it's like the name of the Doctor when Matt Smith's on the floor going, ah, all my lives, you know, it's like that. And the first Doctor's getting plucked out, then the second Doctor and the Brigadier, then Sarah Jane's getting plucked out, canine, love the little canine reference. Mistress, danger, danger, I love that. And then we get, Bessie gets taken as well, lovely little third Doctor classic reference there. What else do we get? We also get, it isn't the first Doctor's exactly, but an actor to play the first Doctor. And we get the Daleks, a little brief cameo of them, that was lovely. And Susan Foreman, the actor who actually played her, is back in the role, and that's nice to see. And her reacting with Tegan and them going off and then them questioning. Susan would stay with the Doctor, whereas Tegan would run away. That's showing their different dynamics. There's another guy I'm going to say. I'm not being offensive to anyone or anything like that. It's just, I don't know his name, so I'm just going to describe him and say, there's a ginger guy. I'm not particularly known of him. I think his name begins with a H. I'm not particularly sure. He's kind of knows how to fly the TARDIS, which is interesting. And that's the thing about this. I am fairly new with the classic era. I've watched the basics, but it's been a while since I've watched the basics. I've watched the Five Doctors endless times. I've watched Genesis. I've watched the first episode of the First Doctor. I've watched the cartoons of the First Doctor reanimated. And I've watched all the multi-doctor stories and the Sixth Doctor last box set, you could say, the Trial of the Doctor, Trial of Time Lord. So I've seen all them, and I've saw Sylvester Remembrance, and I've saw Survival. So I've saw the basics of Doctor Who, but I haven't seen the majority of it. And that's what this is for, in a way, to remind me and get me in it. So when I do eventually delve into it all and start reviewing them all on the channel, this is like a starter pack where I get my head at. So yeah, I don't know that character particularly, but he looks like he can fly the TARDIS, he looks like he knows what he's doing, and that's awesome and interesting. We get the fourth Doctor and Romana from Sharda. They filmed these little scenes. The fourth Doctor didn't want to be in this story because he felt like he's just left the role. It would just be a bit weird if he came back, he felt. So he didn't return. So they used clips to cheat that and call it still the five Doctors by having the fifth Doctor from images of Sharda used in the episode, which was obviously a lost episode until recently where they made it into an animated. That was a nice little unique thing, and they also included the fourth Doctor and Romana in the TARDIS again at the end. That was not lovely. Sarah Jane and the third Doctor dynamic was lovely. She also referenced the fourth Doctor, so we know that where Sarah is in her timeline, she's been left by the Doctor at this point, but she saw him again. That's lovely. The third Doctor seems to know Sarah, so he's met her, so this is near the end of his incarnation, you can kind of say. And the second Doctor, he is just meant to, he's visiting Brigadier and then gets caught up, and then they're surrounded by Yetis and then get took into the death zone of the Time Lords, where basically the Time Lords used to play games on random races and drop them onto this to fight to the death, which was very interesting and dark of the Time Lords to see. We also get Bruce, the president of Gallifrey. He's kind of been corrupted and wants immortality and wants the Ring of Rassilon, is it? And basically he puts that on and then he gets tricked and gets turned into a statue, living forever as a statue. And you can see all the others who've tried as well. along the way. So the president is corrupted and defeated by Rassilon, and we get to see Rassilon near the end, and the doctor's all bumbling about. Also love the contact, and fight it, my dear child. The fifth doctor gets taken over, and yes, third doctor and the second doctor meeting again, lovely. Yes, we also get a mention from the Cybermen, the Yetis, and the Omega for the second doctor, so we know where he is kind of in that timeline. The fifth doctor is where he is or meant to be, and we don't really know where the first doctor is, I don't think. But they're all coming together. The first doctor and Susan meet the fifth doctor, help him up and get ready. Then there's two masters in this. I always thought Dr. Forge was and the Warden of Time was their multi-master story. No, there's another master in this. He's very brief. I love that. So that was interesting. There's these creatures, robots, that take down the Cybermen. They look so good as new villains in the show. They would, if they returned, that would be amazing. They would be such good villains. They're like Weeping Angels, but mixed with Cybermen and going, and it's so awesome. Wow, I want them back. I want them to return, that would be awesome. I don't think I've ever seen them in any other classic story, but you might have. As I've said, I've only seen the majority of them. Have they ever returned, or is it just a one-off in the Five Doctors? Comment down below. What else? There was about it, really. The Cybermen were in it, the Daleks were in it, the Time Lords, obviously, because it was on Gallifrey. We were actually on Gallifrey, I love that. And Bruce, obviously, turning evil, playing against the Doctors, trying to manipulate them to get what he wants, and blaming another Time Lord and him getting executed is interesting. And the Master getting given lives, he can get his regeneration cycle if he helps the Doctor, but then he goes against the Doctor, and how gratifying to kill you. I don't know how many times over, but you know that line. And the chess game, it's all manipulation and playing that massive game. Yes, it all made up quite well. Sarah and the third Doctor's dynamic getting to the Death Zone, Brigadier and the second Doctor getting to the Death Zone was brilliantly tied in. And then we have the fifth Doctor and the first Doctor getting up and getting ready and going to the Death Zone. And it all leading up quite nicely to the reveal, and the Master's about to take down the Doctor, and the Brigadier, hey, nice to see you again, and knocks out the Master. And that's interesting. I love that. There is chemistry there. The Master knows the Brigadier and there's that. Master's took out the Brigadier and Sarah, and all the companions are there, and Susan and all that. They're all there, but the Doctor's all trying to work this out. The fifth Doctor's manipulated the first, the third, and the second are all doing stuff. It's lovely to see them in action. And yeah, then we all get put back to our times after Bruce is taken down and Rassilon is sorted. And then the TARDISes fly off in different directions, and they all go off separately. And Sarah learns there's more, who are they, people? They're me. I'll explain later. Lovely diagram. Lovely classic nod, and going off. It was all quite nice, and they all ended quite well. And then they need a new president. And guess who's going to be president? The Doctor. And the Doctor's like, right, well, my first commands are, see ya. And he's gone off in the TARDIS, and they're like, Doctor! Which caused later problems, I think. But yeah, interesting, and I really enjoyed it. I'm going to give this episode a 10 out of 10. This is my favourite multi-doctor story, better than Day of the Doctor. Now, for a new Who fan like me, this has been the most classic rewatched story I've ever watched. I've probably watched it about 5-6 times altogether, but it's been a while. It's been many, many years since I rewatched this episode, so I didn't know much about it, and it was lovely to watch it again. So yeah, really enjoyed it. Really high story, and really deserves a 10 out of 10. There's only one problem. Wish we had the fourth Doctor, but they couldn't. So kudos to them and pulling it off. That is how you do a multi-doctor story, and hopefully we get more villains and more companions and more doctors in the future in a multi-doctor story than just a few doctors, But yeah, that's it, guys. I will see you guys for another video. next week, every Saturday on the channel, Classical August, and we're trying to get to 200 subscribers. Hopefully we've already hit it by then. If not, you know what to do. Hit the red button and subscribe to Go Doctor Who. And I will see you guys for another video very soon. Have a nice day.